Wow. August 25th, 2022. Four new Excel features plus Wyn's new Power BI book. This was going to be three new features, but as I was working on the video, a fourth feature just came out. Here's what we have. Show changes now comes to desktop Excel. The validation list partial matching works again. It was there, they took it away, now it's back. A new look for Excel options and an amazing new function called the image function that will pull an image from the web into your Excel spreadsheet. Let's take a look at these. All right, first off, show changes. I'm gonna switch over here to a workbook. This workbook saved to OneDrive. So any changes that I make here, I'll change the 1, 2, 3, 4 to 2, 3, 4, 5. They are logging all of these changes. And before, to see the changes from the last 60 days, you'd have to go to Excel Online and open the workbook there. But now on the review tab, show changes, and we can see that that cell B4 was edited from 1, 2, 3, 4 to 2, 3, 4, 5 just now. 5 hours ago, I was doing a seminar and I changed this cell out here. I changed the formula in that cell. Now the thing to remember here is, like, if I would change this number 5555, these cells are all calculated. They're going to change. Those changes aren't logged. It's just the cell that I went to, I typed something in or changed the formula. I can even come here, right click and say show changes, and I'll get just the changes for that item. This has been a great feature in Excel Online, and I'm glad that it finally came to desktop Excel. Next up, validation list partial matching is working again. Here's my list: apple, banana, cherry, Fuji apple, Gala apple, and pineapple. That's the tricky one. Data validation, I'm gonna allow a list, and that list is right over here. All right, we've always had this before, but now if I start to type apple, they were gonna shorten the list down to apple, Fuji apple, and Gala apple, but not pineapple. All right, it doesn't, if it just starts to match in the middle of the word, no deal. Case insensitive. It's not that the A was lowercase, it's that it doesn't have a space before it. It's a cool feature, something we've needed for a long time. New look for Excel options. So if we come here to File, Options, they kind of changed the color here. We have some dark gray that wasn't there before. The checkboxes have a little bit of green, some gray over here. I like it. This first showed up in some of the chart format panes, and we're like, oh, what is this? But it seems to be consistent, and it's you know, everywhere. It's pretty cool. All right, big news. Wyn Hopkins, an Excel MVP in Perth, Australia, has written a beautiful book, Power BI for the Excel Analyst. It's the first Power BI book aimed at people who use Excel all the time. I'm excited about this book. The book's been printed in color. It's coming out in most of the world on November 1st. That's when Amazon will have it. That's when Amazon in your country should have it. But if you happen to be in the USA, I have snagged several cases straight from the printer. Between the printer and the distributor, I had them shipped here, and I can ship those. Unfortunately, USA only, $39.95, and that includes media mail shipping to the United States. There'll be a link down in the YouTube description below, or an I in the top right-hand corner. And check that out. Limited time till these cases run out, and then we're all waiting for Amazon on November 1st. All right, the last feature, a great new function called the image function. What we do is we pass it a URL where that image is, some alt text if we want, and then a sizing option. We'll take a look at that, and height and width. This image right here came from Wyn's website. There is the URL, alternate text, and we'll take a look at that sizing option. That's the one that's a little bit confusing. So if we put a sizing option of 0, it's gonna fit the image in the cell and maintain its aspect ratio. So as a cell gets taller, it will go until it hits the right edge, but then not get any larger than that. If I would change that, here, let's make it a little bit smaller like this. If I would change that argument from a 0 to a 1, then it's gonna fill the cell no matter what. Even though it looks kind of scrunched like that. Scrunched, that's the technical term. If I would change to 2, it's gonna maintain the original size, even if it's bigger than the cell boundary. And then if I change it to 3, then I have to specify the height and the width that I want it to be. Wow, I remember one of my favorite clients called me back in 2002 and said, you know, I want to display pictures in an Excel spreadsheet, the best-selling products. You know, can we do that? And we had to use VBA, and wow, with this image function, we would have been able to just do it, right? I called Jerry, I said, Jerry, you were 20 years ahead of your time They finally came up with your idea, and boy, is it beautiful. All right. So for those of us in Insiders Fast, show changes comes to desktop Excel, the validation list partial matching works, new look for Excel options, the amazing image function. For those of you in the general release, check this out. They're rolling out the 14 new functions to general availability, probably the monthly channel. If you're on semi-annual, you probably still have to wait until, I guess, January. So that's text split, text before, text after, and all of these other great functions. What an exciting day. I happened to just discover the review show changes when I was doing a seminar. And I was about to say, it's not here. You have to go to Excel Online. And lo and behold, it was there. So how exciting is that? Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.